Hello, John Talley here with PartZilla.com. Today I'm going to show you how to set the valve lash on a 2012 Polaris 900 XP Razor. Pretty simple procedure, just need to follow it step by step to get it done correctly. Only takes a few tools. So, let me go get my tools together and I'll show you how to get it done. All right, it's a really short tool list today, guys. Basically, you just need an 8mm socket, decent wrench, most importantly a torque wrench so you can get it set to 89 inch pounds when you're putting those carrier plates back in place. And you're also going to need a good set of feeler gauges. I prefer the angled ones, makes it a lot easier to get under there. So we need to get a baseline so we can see what clearance we do have. What I've done is I've went ahead and pulled out a full set of 250s, the 250 shims. I'm going to go and install all of those, put the cams in place, and then measure to see what our clearances are, and then add or adjust from that point. So let's get it all put together and start doing some measurements. Pretty easy. All you have to do is just put them on top of the valve and they'll just sit in there. Make sure they sit all the way down flat. All right, next, go ahead and put your cups in. Remember, I had these numbered on the bottom. I transferred those numbers up top. Since they're already numbered, we'll put them in the places that corresponds. All right, just to verify that you're getting the cams in the right position, the very end of the intake in the exhaust. It's a very light marking. One ends in a 52 and the other one ends in a 53, the intake being the 52. And there's your 5.2. So this is your intake. All right, when you're doing this, you just want to make sure that the valves are pointed up. We're going to go ahead and do our intake side first. We're going to lay our exhaust cam in there, which we'll get to later. And if you don't have an angled set of feeler gauges like this, I recommend that you get some. It makes life a lot easier. All right, I've got my first measurement. What I'm going to do is just go around to all of them, write down what that measurement is, and then we'll go back and see where we need to add and adjust the thickness of the shims. All right, we've got everything measured. I've got them all written down over here. We started off with 250s across the board, and that's in all locations. What you'll do is you go to your chart, take your measurement, which in this case was 0.229, find the range that it's going to fit in, which is going to be 0.226 to 0.250, and then you come across to the 250 range, and that tells you that if you come down, that's going to be a 258. So I'm going to go back through, I'm going to lift this off, go back through, and then I'm going to exchange my 250s for whatever that chart tells me it should be. Make sure you keep everything in the same order. All right, we got our new shims in place, got our tappets in place. What I'm going to do now is go ahead and once again put in the cams just temporarily, and then we're going to check our measurements, make sure they're within range. All right, once again, when you make your measurement, you want to make sure your lobes are pointing up at the same angle as the valve stem itself. So about right there. And also remember that your intake and exhaust have different tolerances. Your tolerance for your intake is somewhere in between 0.125 and 0.175 millimeters, or in between 5 and 7 thousandths if you're measuring in inches. So each intake needs to be one of these three. Let's see where we are. All right. Right in the middle. That's where I want to be. I'll accept one of the other two, but that middle one, that's what I want. All right, the intake's looking good. Want to check the exhaust, and that's going to be on in between 0.275 and 0.325 millimeters, if you're doing standard, 11 to 13 thousandths. All my measurements check out. Here's what we need to do next. Let's go ahead and take them back off one more time and go ahead and get assembly lube on all the buckets, on all the top of the tappets, and then in the bearing riding surfaces here and here. So let's get it pulled back apart one last time, get it put back together. Then I think it's actually time to mount it to the block. All right, guys, they are set and ready to go. Well, listen, one thing that I didn't mention is the torque on the camshaft carrier bolts. That needs to be 89 inch-pounds, so make sure you get that set before you actually start up the machine. Well, listen, if you need any of the parts that we use to rebuild this, come find us at partzilla.com and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments, just leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. Until next time, we just want to say thanks for watching.